Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Viking and the Witch of the Fjord. Chapter 1. Shadows of the Fjord. The Viking longship, adorned with dragon heads that glinted in the pale sunlight, cut through the churning waters like a mythical beast on the prowl. Thorstein stood at the helm, his eyes fixed on the distant shores of the fjord, the land shadowed by the malevolent presence of a witch whose dark magic held the land in a vice-like grip. The sea around him roared with a furious determination, mirroring Thorstein's unwavering resolve. The salty mist clung to his weathered beard as he navigated through the relentless waves. The crew, a band of fierce warriors, moved in unison, their muscles tense with anticipation for the impending confrontation with the witch. As the longship approached the fjord's entrance, the atmosphere changed. The air grew thick with an eerie stillness, and the sky above darkened, as if the very heavens frowned upon this cursed land. The cliffs on either side of the fjord rose like sentinels, their sheer faces cloaked in mist, shrouded in the mystery of the malevolent force that held sway. Thorstein, undeterred by the ominous aura, ordered the unfurling of the dragon-headed sail, a defiant display of the Viking spirit against the encroaching darkness. The longship surged forward, propelled by the wind and the collective will of the crew, cutting through the dense fog that clung to the fjord like the whispers of a thousand forgotten souls. Navigating through the narrowing channel, the longship entered the fjord's heart. The landscape unfolded a tapestry of craggy cliffs, hidden coves, and foreboding caves. Thorstein, his eyes sharp and unyielding, scanned the shores for any signs of the witch's presence. The tales of her malevolence, whispered by those who dared to speak her name, fueled his determination. As the longship sailed further into the fjord, the crew felt the weight of an invisible force, a palpable malevolence that hung in the air. Shadows danced along the cliffs, and the sea beneath seemed to writhe with an unnatural energy. Thorstein, undeterred, gripped the hilt of his sword, a blade forged in the fires of countless battles, now destined to clash with the sorcery that tainted the land. The fjord's shores narrowed, revealing hidden caves that yawned like the maw of some ancient beast. Thorstein, fueled by the legends of magical artifacts concealed within these labyrinthine depths, ordered the longship to anchor. Armed with his sword and a torch, he descended into the darkness, a lone warrior ready to confront the unseen forces that lurked in the abyss. The cave's interior, bathed in an eerie blue glow from luminescent fungi, stretched before Thorstein like a subterranean realm. The walls whispered with a language that transcended mortal understanding, a symphony of ancient incantations and forgotten prophecies. The air became heavy with the scent of enchantment, and shadows danced along the uneven rock surfaces. Undeterred by the spectral atmosphere, Thorstein pressed on. The cave's twists and turns seemed to defy logic, leading him deeper into the heart of the fjord's mysteries. Strange symbols adorned the walls, cryptic runes that hinted at the arcane forces that held the land captive. Thorstein, unversed in the ways of magic, felt the weight of an unseen presence as he moved through the subterranean labyrinth. The cave, however, had no intention of surrendering its secrets willingly. Thorstein encountered illusions that tested the very fabric of his reality. Phantom foes, that materialized and dissolved like specters in the shadows. The air hummed with whispers, and the torchlight flickered as if threatened by unseen hands. Yet Thorstein pressed on. The echoes of his footsteps reverberated through the caverns, a testament to his indomitable spirit. He glimpsed artifacts, forgotten relics of an age when magic and steel coexisted. A sword that shimmered with an ethereal glow. A talisman that resonated with ancient powers. Each discovery fueled his determination to confront the malevolent witch. The deeper Thorstein ventured, the more the cave revealed. Hidden chambers unveiled murals that depicted the witch's dark deeds, a visual chronicle of a fjord ensnared by sorcery. The murals hinted at the artifact's significance, the keys to unlocking the witch's vulnerabilities, each possessing a unique power that, when combined, could unravel her dark enchantments. As Thorstein traversed the labyrinth, the cave seemed to respond to his presence. Hidden passageways opened before him, and the very stones whispered ancient incantations, guiding him towards the artifact's resting places. The air crackled with a potent energy, a symphony of the arcane that resonated with the Viking's heartbeat. The artifacts, nestled within the heart of the cave, awaited their liberator. Thorstein, now armed with the magical arsenal, emerged from the subterranean depths, his eyes ablaze with a newfound purpose. The cave, its secrets laid bare, seemed to exhale a sigh of acknowledgement, a silent tribute to the Viking who dared to confront the shadows of the fjord. Returning to the longship, Thorstein felt the weight of the artifacts in his grasp, a tangible connection to the arcane forces that gripped the land. The crew, their eyes reflecting a mix of awe and trepidation, prepared for the next leg of the journey. The shadows of the fjord, now infused with the light of the artifacts, seemed to retreat in the face of Thorstein's newfound power. As the longship set sail deeper into the heart of the fjord, Thorstein's mind brimmed with determination. The cave's mysteries were but the beginning of a perilous odyssey, one that would take him through ancestral woods, lost villages, and the very vortex where the witch's malevolence converged. The artifacts pulsed with energy, and Thorstein, his heart ablaze with Viking valor, steered the ship towards the shadows that clung to the fjord, like a curse waiting to be broken. Chapter 2. Caves of Enchantment. The longship glided through the fjord's dark waters, the artifacts safely stowed away. Thorstein, his eyes fixed on the jagged cliffs that loomed overhead, navigated toward the next leg of his odyssey, the ancestral woods, where the spirits whispered ancient truths and the remnants of forgotten villages held cryptic clues. The crew, their expressions a mix of anticipation and unease, braced themselves for the journey ahead. The fjord, now veiled in the eerie light of the artifacts, seemed to ripple with a newfound energy, a silent acknowledgement of the Viking's quest. As the longship approached the fjord's edge, the ancestral woods revealed themselves, an arboreal realm untouched by the passage of time. Towering trees with limbs that stretched like ancient sentinels stood sentinel over a forest floor, carpeted with moss and adorned with celestial flowers that glowed in the dappled sunlight. Thorstein, guided by the whispers of the spirits, disembarked with a resolute stride. The air in the woods carried the fragrance of ancient wisdom, and the sound of rustling leaves seemed to echo with tales of a bygone era. The artifacts at Thorstein's side pulsed with a rhythmic energy, attuned to the natural forces that permeated the ancestral woods. As the Viking delved deeper into the heart of the woods, the landscape shifted. Trees, their bark etched with runes and symbols, revealed themselves as living records of the past. Thorstein ran his fingers along the ancient inscriptions, his senses attuned to the tales that emanated from the very essence of the woods. The spirits of the woods, ethereal beings with eyes that mirrored the depths of the ancient trees, materialized before Thorstein. They spoke in a language that resonated with the whispers of the wind, an ancient tongue that conveyed truths known only to those who dared to seek the wisdom of the arboreal realm. Guided by the spirits, Thorstein ventured deeper into the woods, encountering enchanted clearings where cosmic energies intertwined with earthly forces. The artifacts, pulsating with a soft glow, seemed to harmonize with the natural energies that surrounded them. It became evident that the ancestral woods held not only the secrets of the past, but also the key to unlocking the artifact's full potential. Amidst the celestial flowers and luminescent fungi that carpeted the forest floor, Thorstein discovered hidden altars, sacred spaces, where the artifacts could be attuned to the elemental forces. The spirits, their presence a guiding breeze through the ancient boughs, directed Thorstein in a ritual that awakened the artifact's dormant powers. As he chanted ancient incantations and imbued the artifacts with the energies of the ancestral woods, a surge of power coursed through Thorstein's veins. The artifacts glowed with an intensified brilliance, their purpose unveiled in the sacred dance of cosmic forces. The Viking, now a conduit of both magic and steel, felt the weight of his newfound responsibility. The ancestral woods had bequeathed him the means to challenge the malevolent witch. Emboldened by the woods' revelations, Thorstein set forth towards the remnants of villages lost in the folds of time. The spirits whispered tales of a bygone era, a time when the witch's dark magic first cast its shadow over the land. The artifacts, now charged with the energies of the ancestral woods, seemed to hum with an anticipatory resonance, as if aware of the pivotal role they played in unraveling the fjord's dark history. As Thorstein approached the ruins of forgotten villages, the artifacts guided him towards crumbling structures that bore witness to the witch's malevolence. Broken walls, once vibrant with the echoes of life, now stood as silent testimonies to the tyranny that had befallen the land. Thorstein, unyielding in his quest, scoured the ruins for clues that would lead him closer to the witch's lair. Amongst the dilapidated homes and overgrown pathways, Thorstein discovered fragments of ancient manuscripts, tattered remnants that hinted at the witch's origins and the source of her dark powers. The spirits, lingering in the spectral remnants of the villages, offered cryptic insights, urging Thorstein to piece together the puzzle that spanned generations. As the Viking traversed the ruins, shadows seemed to dance upon the broken stones, an ethereal retelling of the villagers' plight. He glimpsed spectral figure shadows frozen in time, forever etched in the moments before the witch's malevolence had consumed them. The artifacts, now resonating with a somber energy, absorbed the echoes of the villagers' despair. Guided by the spirits and fueled by the artifacts' newfound resonance, Thorstein deciphered the fragments of the ancient manuscripts. The tales spoke of the witch's pact with otherworldly entities, her insatiable hunger for power, and the artifact's creation as a last resort by a desperate sorcerer who sought to defy her dark influence. Armed with the knowledge gleaned from the ruins, Thorstein pressed on. The artifacts, their glow casting an ethereal luminescence upon the path ahead, seemed to echo the determination in his heart. The ancestral woods and the remnants of lost villages had unveiled the layers of the fjord's tragic history, setting the stage for the final confrontation with the malevolent witch. The shadows that clung to the land quivered as if in anticipation, sensing the Viking's inexorable advance. Chapter 3: Ancestral Woods and Lost Villages. Thorstein, now armed with artifacts pulsating with the energy of the ancestral woods, continued his journey through the fjord. The spectral remnants of forgotten villages faded behind him as the longship sailed deeper into the heart of the malevolent domain. Guided by the spirits and the artifact's luminous glow, the Viking approached the vortex where the witch's dark powers were said to converge. The fjord's waters, once tumultuous and foreboding, now seemed to reflect the newfound light of Thorstein's resolve. As the longship sailed through the narrowing channel, the cliffs on either side rose like silent sentinels, guardians of the secrets that awaited within the vortex. The ancestral woods whispered tales of cosmic energies and ancient prophecies that converged in this perilous realm. Thorstein, standing at the brow, gazed into the heart of the vortex. The water seemed to swirl with an otherworldly force, a maelstrom that mirrored the clash of celestial and earthly powers. The artifacts, now attuned to the cosmic forces, emitted a gentle hum, a harmonic resonance that echoed the Viking's heartbeat. As the longship entered the vortex, the very fabric of reality seemed to warp. The sky above twisted into kaleidoscopic patterns, and the air buzzed with an otherworldly energy. The spirits of the ancestral woods, now ethereal wisps that danced upon the winds, guided Thorstein through the celestial currents that intertwined with the earthly realm. Navigating through the vortex, the longship sailed through meandering currents and swirling eddies that threatened to pull it into the abyss. Thorstein, his eyes fixated on the horizon, sensed the convergence of realms, an intersection where the cosmic and terrestrial forces met in a dance as old as time itself. As the longship emerged from the vortex, the landscape transformed. The celestial energies painted the skies with hues unseen by mortal eyes, and the air crackled with the essence of magic. Thorstein found himself in an otherworldly realm, a cosmic tapestry where stars formed patterns that seemed to tell tales of ancient deities and forgotten civilizations. Guided by the spirits, Thorstein traversed through meadows adorned with stardust and mountaintops that brushed against the very edges of the cosmos. The artifacts, now resonating with the celestial energies, seemed to guide him towards a celestial nexus, a convergence point where the cosmic forces merged with the earthly realm. In the heart of the celestial realm, Thorstein encountered ethereal beings, celestial guardians who watched over the cosmic tapestry. Their eyes, radiant with the wisdom of eons, met his with a silent acknowledgement. The celestial guardians, aware of his quest, gestured towards the cosmic nexus, a point where the energies of the earthly and celestial realms intertwined. Approaching the cosmic nexus, Thorstein felt a surge of cosmic energies coursing through him. The celestial guardians, with a silent nod, empowered the artifacts to resonate with the very fabric of the universe. The artifacts, now imbued with celestial energies, emanated a brilliance that rivaled the stars themselves. As Thorstein held the artifacts aloft, the cosmic nexus responded. A celestial gateway materialized, an arch of celestial confluence adorned with symbols that mirrored the constellations above. The spirits of the ancestral woods, now ethereal whispers that echoed through the cosmic expanse, urged Thorstein to step through the gateway and confront the witch on the cosmic plane. With determination etched on his face, Thorstein stepped through the arch of celestial confluence. The celestial expanse unfolded, a realm where stars formed constellations that told tales of cosmic beings and celestial events. Spirits of ancient deities danced in harmonious patterns, and Thorstein, attuned to the celestial energies, became a custodian of the cosmic gateway that linked the earthly realm to the celestial wonders above. As he emerged from the arch of celestial confluence, the celestial energies within Thorstein pulsed with an intensified brilliance. The celestial guardians, with nods of acknowledgement, guided him back towards the vortex where the earthly and cosmic forces converged. The vortex, now a gateway between realms, awaited the Viking's return. As Thorstein sailed back through the vortex, the celestial energies melded with the terrestrial realm. The longship, guided by cosmic currents and earthly winds, emerged from the vortex into the familiar waters of the fjord. The celestial nexus, its purpose fulfilled, faded into the cosmic expanse. The artifacts, now resonating with both celestial and earthly energies, seemed to vibrate with a harmonious frequency. The spirits of the ancestral woods, carried upon the cosmic winds, whispered their gratitude. Thorstein, now a bearer of celestial energies, stood at the helm of the longship, his gaze fixed on the vortex's fading glow. The longship sailed back towards the ancestral woods and the remnants of forgotten villages, a Viking now touched by the celestial tapestry and empowered by the very forces that governed the universe. The celestial energies within him resonated with the earthly realm, and as he approached the heart of the fjord, the vortex that had once been a source of malevolence now stood as a gateway to both cosmic wonders and the land he sought to free. The spirits, now ethereal whispers that lingered in the air, guided Thorstein towards the final confrontation with the witch. The celestial energies within the artifacts and within the Viking himself pulsed with a renewed vigor, ready to confront the malevolence that awaited within the fjord's heart. The shadows that had clung to the land quivered, sensing the cosmic energies that now infused the Viking's quest. Chapter 4. Vortex of Confrontation. Thorstein, now a vessel of celestial energies, sailed the longship towards the heart of the fjord, where the vortex awaited a gateway between the earthly and cosmic realms. The celestial nexus within him resonated with the artifacts, creating a harmonious symphony of power that echoed across the waters. As the longship approached the vortex, the air crackled with anticipation. The artifacts, now radiant with both celestial and earthly energies, hummed in unison, attuned to the cosmic forces that intertwined with the malevolent witch's dark powers. The spirits of the ancestral woods, their ethereal whispers guiding Thorstein, danced upon the winds, urging the Viking towards the impending confrontation. The vortex, once a menacing force, now seemed to pulse with a rhythmic energy, responding to the celestial frequencies emanating from the artifacts. The sky above, painted with hues of cosmic brilliance, reflected the impending clash of forces, a celestial battleground where the earthly and the otherworldly would collide. As the longship entered the vortex, the waters churned with a cosmic maelstrom. Thorstein, his eyes ablaze with determination, stood at the prow, holding the artifacts aloft. The celestial energies within him resonated with the vortex's chaotic dance, creating a powerful synergy that defied the very laws of the earthly realm. In the heart of the vortex, a silhouette emerged, a spectral figure cloaked in darkness, the malevolent witch herself. Her eyes, twin orbs of malevolence, locked onto Thorstein with a cold intensity. A sinister smile curled on her lips as she extended her arms, calling forth dark energies that mirrored the cosmic forces at play. The clash began, a battle waged on the precipice of existence. Thorstein, wielding the artifacts as conduits of both earthly and celestial powers, faced the witch who, in turn, harnessed the malevolence that had gripped the fjord for centuries. The celestial energies crackled against the dark forces, creating an otherworldly spectacle that played out across the cosmic tapestry. Sword against sorcery, the clash reverberated through the vortex. Thorstein's every strike echoed with the harmonious resonance of the celestial energies, disrupting the witch's incantations and unraveling the dark threads that bound the fjord. The artifacts, pulsating with newfound strength, absorbed and redirected the malevolent forces unleashed by the witch. The very fabric of the vortex seemed to quiver, a manifestation of the cosmic struggle between light and darkness. The celestial nexus within Thorstein surged, intertwining with the earthly realm, creating a focal point where the witch's malevolence waned against the cosmic might that the Viking now embodied. In a moment of revelation, the artifacts unleashed a burst of celestial energy, a radiant shockwave that rippled through the vortex. The witch, caught off guard, recoiled as the celestial forces disrupted her dark enchantments. The vortex itself seemed to respond, resonating with the harmonious frequencies that now dominated the clash. With a final resounding strike, Thorstein cleaved through the malevolent witch's defenses. The artifacts, now aglow with a celestial radiance, seemed to pierce through the very heart of the witch's darkness. She wailed as her powers unraveled, dissipating into the cosmic winds that carried them away like echoes of a bygone era. As the celestial energies within the artifacts reached their crescendo, the vortex itself began to dissipate. The malevolent force that had gripped the fjord for centuries faded, replaced by a serene calm that spread across the waters. The celestial nexus within Thorstein pulsed with a triumphant glow as he stood victorious against the forces of darkness. The spirits of the ancestral woods, their ethereal presence felt in the fading winds, whispered words of gratitude. The vortex, once a gateway to malevolence, transformed into a cosmic gateway, a portal that connected the earthly realm to the celestial wonders above. Thorstein, now a custodian of both realms, gazed into the expanse with a sense of fulfillment. The longship sailed out of the dissipating vortex, leaving behind the celestial battleground. The fjord, once shrouded in malevolence, now basked in the celestial glow of newfound freedom. The artifacts, still resonating with both earthly and celestial energies, stood as silent witnesses to the cosmic clash that had unfolded. Thorstein, his quest fulfilled, guided the longship towards the ancestral woods where the spirits lingered. The cosmic energies that now flowed through him connected him to both realms, creating a bond that transcended mortal understanding. The spirits, their ethereal whispers a chorus of approval, surrounded the Viking in a dance of gratitude. As Thorstein stepped onto the shores of the ancestral woods, the artifacts seemed to acknowledge their role in the cosmic drama. The celestial nexus within him, still resonating with the harmonious frequencies, attested to the Viking's journey won that had transcended the boundaries of the earthly realm and confronted the malevolent forces that sought to shroud the land in perpetual twilight. The spirits, their whispers now carried by the cosmic winds, faded into the tapestry of the universe. Thorstein, now a keeper of both earthly and celestial energies, watched as the longship, bathed in the glow of newfound freedom, sailed away towards the horizon. The fjord, once ensnared in shadows, now stood as a testament to the Viking who dared to confront the malevolent forces and restore the cosmic balance that governed the realms.